Hi, welcome. This session is dedicated to show you one of the theories that we develop in our book, How to Think Strategically, Your Roadmap to Innovation and Results. Well, this is actually the key strategic framework because it's built on our belief that the strategy is not linear. In fact, many people think that strategy is a subsequent set of steps that you go from A to B. Well, we believe that there are such steps, but they are not linear, i.e. there are plenty of loops. And for this reason, we built this nice framework that we call the strategy roundabouts. And basically, as you can see, it is a big round, but it's full of roundabouts in between. And this to convey two messages. First, that strategy starts, but it never ends. And second, that any strategic process has a number of loops that are there and you cannot avoid them. You might be very lucky and you go straight at each roundabout, but that is quite rare. At some point you will have to conceive that you have to go back because some of your assumptions are not correct. In fact, that's the next big point about strategy that we want to make sure you get right, which is strategy, it's about the future. And as such, it's always an hypothesis. And it's an hypothesis of the destination where you want to get to. It's an hypothesis about how you want to get there. And in some cases, even an hypothesis about where you are, although that should be pretty certain. Well, let me take you through the different steps. First and foremost, it's important that at the center of the roundabout, there is something that we call organizational culture, or better, in the book, we call it the invisible ant. This is, or those are, all the mental models, the shared assumption that the firms has about how to do things, about the way to work, what is acceptable, what is not acceptable. And it's at the center of the framework because this will have a huge impact in every single step of the strategic development process, which starts always with what we call uncovering the situation. Well, it starts because of a trigger. It might be an opportunity. So there is a possibility of doing something new in the firm. There is a possibility of entering a new market. There is a possibility of a new technology that could bring new products and new services. Or on the other hand, it might be problems. Things that do not work well, and as executives and as members of the organization, we want to get better. All those observations will make the first step. The problem with those is that they are observations, and normally there are many. So the first step to do in this process is to try to classify them, to group them, segment them, organize them in a way that are meaningful for your eyes, and that you can try to draw some insights. Once you got those grouping or those classification, as in any scientific process, then you can start to imagine and verify some correlations, i.e. links between all those observations. And through this process of linking up correlation, you move to the second step, which is what we call identifying core challenges. What are core challenges? Well, core challenges is what we call a big problem. And how do you identify a big problem? Well, it's a problem or it's an opportunity, i.e. a challenge, that can explain a number of observations, more than one. And the you will see in the book and in the app that there are techniques such as the effect cause effect, which will help you to uncover those core challenges. But the point here is strategy is about choices and the choice is about what to do, but most importantly, what not to do. And learning about core challenges and identifying core challenges will help you to choose which battle to fight. Once you identify the core challenges, then you move on to the next phase. And as you can see, and I remind you, those are roundabouts. You might have found a core challenge, or you may not have found a core challenge that brings you back to seek further information and more insights. But then once you move on, you will eventually get to the third point, which is what we call working out the core challenges, i.e. find the solutions. And the beauty of this is that once you're doing the process of core challenge identification, almost intuitively, you will come up with solutions. And those solutions can be listed down, and they will be the object of the next phase. But in the case you haven't come up with a solution, there are a number of exercises and a number of things that you can do, such as putting in around the table a number of people from with diverse background, which will enhance the creativity of the group creativity to solve a particular core challenge. In fact, this is something very important, and in the creativity, the ability to find a solution that leverage the maximum at the maximum all the ingredients you have already in the company is the secret to be always aligned with organizational culture. Because if you come up with solutions that or initiatives that they will not be accepted or acceptable for the organizational culture, i.e. for the way people do things, you will have a much bigger hurdle to overcome in order to implement it. And now, once you have a set of hypotheses about the potential solution of core challenges, now you have the next phase. This is something pretty interesting, and it's something that we believe is quite novel to introduce it in the strategic process, which is what we call reducing uncertainty. All solutions that you developed, as well as the solution to the core challenges, they rely on hypotheses. Yeah? You may have done a lot of number crunching, you may have done a lot of market analysis and a lot of quantitative analysis, but still, those are hypotheses. And in order to reduce the uncertainty, i.e. reduce the risk that the solution will not work, it's very, very important to go through a process of experimentation. This is what we think will make the uncertainty to be reduced. Experimentation will be done on a number of levels, and as you will have seen in the book, or you will see in the book, we identify three levels of hypothesis that needs to be tested. The first being value, i.e. will the initiative you identify create value by way of having benefits that outweighs the effort. Second, growth. Can this initiative be scalable or be scaled up to a large, meaningful group of people that will increase the impact of the initiative? And last but not least, will this initiative be sustainable? I.e., how easy will it be to be copied by an adversary, by a competitor, and how easy will it be for the invisible hand, i.e. the organizational culture, to accept it. Going through progressively this type of testing will enhance you, will help you to reduce the risk of any strategic initiative that you intend to launch. Now, last but not least, we have a set of initiatives that respond to a core challenge. We test them, we experiment on them. Of course, we don't have the full certainty, but we have a very good likelihood that those will work. Then we can launch what we call execution or pivot. Pivot means abandon what we've done so far, to go back to the process or move forward to new initiatives. But in the execution, you will see that there is a number of activities that can be done in order to further reduce the uncertainty of such exercise. So this is the strategic roundabout. It is a framework. Hopefully it conveys the messages that I just got you. I invite you to read it through the book, and as you, as always in the spirit of this book, we invite you to send us back feedback through the website or directly by email. Thank you very much.